Sky Watchers, and welcome to the sky above us. I'm James Albury, and I'm your tour guide to the night sky. We have two full moons this month, but the second one is going to be special because it happens on Halloween night. Let me show you. The moon is our nearest neighbor in space, and as it orbits the Earth, it goes through its usual phases: new, crescent, quarter, gibbous, and full. It takes the moon approximately 29 and a half days to go from phase to identical phase. This is called the moon's sonatic period. Sonatic means same node, and that corresponds to the moon's alignment with the Earth and the sun. The term month is connected to this period of lunar revolution. We used to call it a month, and we shortened it to month in modern times. As a result, we always get to see at least one full moon each month. Occasionally, though, if a full moon happens on or shortly after the first day of a month that has 31 days in it, we can have two full moons in one month. We call that a blue moon. The moon doesn't actually turn blue during a blue moon. The term blue moon originally was used to describe the third of four full moons to occur in one season. However, in March 1946, a misprint in Sky and Telescope magazine began the modern definition of the term, where it describes the occurrence of having two full moons in the same calendar month. To me, that's more exciting. You're probably saying to yourself, why is this blue moon so special? Well, if you're a fan of Halloween imagery, you're probably familiar with the classic scene of a witch riding her broomstick silhouetted by a rising full moon. Well, believe it or not, most Halloweens don't have a full moon. But in 2020, we get one. Jack Horkheimer, the late executive director of the Miami Space Transit Planetarium and creator of the PBS TV series Stargazers, mentioned this particular full moon in a video interview almost 20 years ago. And despite my rapidly advancing age, I remembered it. So that's why I devoted a whole episode to it. Don't you love it when a plan comes together?
We discovered, strange as it may seem, there will not be a full moon on Halloween again until the year 2020.
Okay, let's see where the planets are going to be between now and Halloween night. Okay, we have our sky set up for 8 p.m. on October 21st, facing south. Among the stars of Sagittarius the Centaur, you'll see the waxing crescent moon just to the west of Jupiter, the largest planet in our solar system. On the night of October 22nd, the moon will form a nice little triangle with Jupiter and Saturn. Then on October 23rd, the moon will enter Capricornus, leaving Saturn and Jupiter behind. Let's jump ahead to October 28th, at the same time, 8 p.m. We'll see the waxing gibbous moon nearing the red planet Mars. On the 29th, it zips past Mars, and on Halloween night, October 31st, we have our blue pumpkin moon. Now, if you're an early morning person, check out the sky on the morning of November 12th. If we go outside at 6 a.m. that day, we'll see a gorgeous waning crescent moon hovering delicately above both Venus and Mercury. All three objects will be in the constellation Virgo, and the bright star Spica will be there showing off as well. So, my friends, head outside and check out the blue pumpkin moon on Halloween night. If you miss it this year, you won't see a full moon on Halloween again until the year 2039. So yeah, go ahead and mark your calendar. And if you'd like to support our program, click on the Patreon link in the description and you could qualify for autographed The Sky Above Us memorabilia, and you could see your name in the credits of our next episode. Have a safe and happy Halloween while you keep looking up.